The lights have come on, the stage has been set, and the room reverberates with all kinds of energy. Nervous, excited, confident, and eager. Good evening, audience. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you to an evening that is very special to us. The 9th annual day celebration of the Universal School. Dear parents, I'm sure that you have looked forward to this day as much as the kids. So fasten your seat belts as the evening's emotions and music go through the roof. I now invite Anushka of grade 10, Tahan of grade 2, Nirali of junior KG, and Jimit of grade 5 to take the program ahead.
Good evening, everyone. Before we begin, I request everyone to switch off their mobile phones or keep them on silent mode during the show.
I also request you to not stand up or get out of your seats during the performance, as that will distract us.
Please don't click pictures, as the photos of the event will be made available to you.
Once again, a hearty welcome to all from the Universal family.
Children are one-third of our population and all of our future. I take this opportunity to welcome the children and teachers from Seva Sadan and Muktangan. We are thrilled to have you with us. Thank you for joining us today this evening. I would also like to acknowledge Ms. Fatima Rashid, head of the counseling department for the Universal Schools, and Ms. Janet Rodrigues, our head coordinator, who are with us today. The presence of our guests have made this evening an even special one.
Nirali, do you like music?
I love music.
Everybody loves music. You don't even have to ask.
I agree, Tahan. Music is a language in itself, a language that is understood and loved by all.
So let's tap our feet and sway our heads to a performance by the school choir. Let's hear it for them, audience.
Nirali, don't start speaking.
They are on.
performance that was. A great beginning to the celebration. Don't you agree, Nirali?
Absolutely, I enjoyed that so much. Didn't you, audience?
We have had a spectacular year till now, and with a lot still left to unfold.
To our great joy and honor, we have with us Ms. Jyoti Tanna. She laid the foundation of the Each One Teach One organization in 1983 with 5 children. Till date, it has reached out to 10,000 children, and the journey continues. The vision of Each One Teach One is to enrich the lives of the needy children in urban slums and rural India by strengthening their intellectual and emotional capabilities. We welcome you, ma'am. Thank you for your presence here. I request our grade 10 students to felicitate ma'am with a token of our love. We also have with us Ms. Katie Bagley, who is an author and naturalist. Through her writing, ma'am strives to bring about awareness and sensitize the young to the environment and wildlife. When the BMC came up with revamping the Rani Bagh in 2007, she joined 4 other women to form the Save Rani Bagh Foundation, which campaigned to save more than 3,000 trees that exist there. Thank you for joining us, ma'am.
A leader is one who knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way. We are fortunate to be led by someone who is an embodiment of these values, our principal, Ms. Zareen Virji. I request you, ma'am, to address the audience.
Good evening, parents. Louder. That's better. I hope you're all geared up for the show that's going to follow. Good. I would also like to welcome our guests, Ms. Jyoti Tanna, a very dear friend for many years, and of course, Ms. Katie Bagley. Lovely to have you two ladies with us. I'm also extremely happy to have students and teachers from Muktangan, and students and teachers from Seva Sadan. I'm so happy our students get to perform for you as well, and we would love to have your feedback. Yes, it's a great day. You've seen our report, all the stuff that has been happening in school. Of course, you have borne witness to it. I firmly believe that success in a child's life begins at home. And so the credit for what your children are like definitely goes to you. But we also share it. Yes, yes, let's hear it for our parents. The values that you put into your children is extremely important. And then it is the school that takes them forward in their formative years. And that's what we have been endeavoring to do. And I thank our chairman, Mr. Jesus Lal, and our director, Ms. Pinky Pujara, for giving us this wonderful school. Having said that, I think I would also like to appreciate all those who make the school tick on a daily basis. And the first name that comes to mind is that of Ms. Dilnaz Bharucha, the vice principal. Ms. Bharucha, who is seated with the sound, and so you can't see her, works very hard. She's a pillar of the school, and she really glues all the elements together. Thank you, ma'am. We appreciate what you do for us. I would also like to thank Mr. Amay Mahajan. Amay, if you're around, do step out so the parents can acknowledge your service. Coordinator of the secondary section.
Thank you, sir.
Miss Namrita Dauda, who is with the lights, and therefore you will not see her here, but she is coordinating the primary section, and we thank you, Ms. Namrita, for your service to the school. And coming to the show, I would first like to thank our service providers, Shyamak Dawar Education. You know how much they put into every show and every child. We are really proud to be partnering with Shyamak Dawar. Royal Padamsi's Academy of Creative Expression has also helped us this time with the tableaus. Ms. Dale, if you're here, do step forward so we can acknowledge you. Thank you, the team from ACE. The team from Furtado School of Music, you already had occasion to sample a bit of their stuff. And we are grateful for their instructors and all that they put into this school. And all those like Miss Rupal. Miss Rupal, why don't you step forward? Looking at all the... all the props and the sets she has designed along with SDE. We have Miss Mezabine, who has helped with the play, and Miss Janet from our central team. Ladies, do step out so we can acknowledge you. Thank you so much. Miss Rekha is sitting with the audiovisuals. She always works very hard to make the report come alive before your eyes. So thank you, ma'am, for your service. The ICT department and all the various elements that bring, you know, it's almost a professional show, I think you will agree with me. And we are not trained, but somehow we work together and we make it happen year after year. And while some of us share the limelight, most of the other teachers are behind taking care of the children. So I think we need to appreciate all those who are doing that as well. So thank you. I don't want to stand between you and the show. Have a great evening, parents. And I thank you so much for your continued support and confidence in our school.
Thank you for those wonderful words, ma'am.
Nirali, we are on stage here.
When will the show begin?
When will the skate begin?
Calm down, you all. The moment that we have all been waiting for has finally arrived.
So let's sit back and relax as we transport you to a whole different era through our skit.
Glimpses of Indian History.
Thank you.
Faces, what's up?
Nothing's up, bro. Everything's down.
Why? Is Sid's birthday bash called off?
That's very much on track, Rohan.
Then what is it? Come on, guys, please enlighten me.
It's a history exam. That's what has got us down.
Why,
that may be a cakewalk for you, Rohan.
Yeah, scholar of the class.
Don't forget, it's 5,000 years of history.
Exactly. No one knows where to begin. Look, exams come and go. Looking glum won't help. Just mug it up.
It's not so simple, Rohan. The portion is so vast.
And the dates and names and dynasties. Mighty puzzling, if you ask me.
I have found a great reference book for Indian history.
That's a start. Show it to me.
Books are passé. Use technology, my friend, and the pages of history will unravel before you.
Do you really think books and iPads will do the trick? They will only help to a point. If you want the full story of India, you'd better come to me.
Who are you?
I am the one who has seen it all. The shame, the glory, the brutality, and the bravery. The invaders and the invaded. The follies of the great kings. The extraordinary acts of ordinary men and women.
Then you must be a time traveler.
Time is of no relevance to me, but you could call me that if you wish.
Are you Mother India?
You could call me that too.
Mother India, but aren't you supposed to be dressed in a white sari with a golden crown?
I can dress any which way I want. The Indian woman has seen many kinds of dress from the beginning of time.
Wow, we are in the presence of a goddess, live. I always wanted to see one.
Sorry to break this up. Saira, Michelle, come here.
Don't be so credulous. She's some kind of con woman. Let's get
on. I'm not here to cheat you, Rohan. I'm here to help. But if you don't want me to, that's fine. I shall leave you to your endeavors.
No, no, please stay. Yes, we want your help.
Why don't you start at the very beginning?
With pleasure. As you must have read, the story of India goes back to the Indus Valley civilization.
You're talking of Mohenjo-daro, aren't you?
That means the mound of the dead in Sindhi.
Imran, I'm glad you remember something of what you've read.
That means it was in Pakistan.
The sites discovered so far are spread over a vast area, stretching from present-day Afghanistan to Pakistan to India.
What were those people like?
fine, enterprising lot of men and women, more civilized than your so-called civilization. The cities were more organized than what I see now. Houses were built of burnt bricks, with square courtyards, bathrooms, and drains to carry the dirty water away. The streets were broad and straight, so that the chariots and bullock carts could move easily. Among the people were skilled craftsmen who could make fine pots of clay and simple implements from copper and bronze. A truly peaceful population. Yes, I did read that no weapons are found in these ruins.
But what happened? How did they get wiped out?
That's a long story. Nothing lasts forever. But I thank Jhulelal for this marvelous civilization.
Who is Jhulelal?
I think I know. Isn't he the god of the Sindhis?
Let's not classify gods. I don't know where that will take us.
Mika Singh, yo Hani Singh.
Oh, lal meri pat, rakhiyo bala jhule lalan. Lal meri
pat. Come on, parents, let's make some noise. Let's see all your hands up, parents. Come on.
Sevan da sahi jawad kalender, tamad mast kalender. Ali da pehla number, tamad mast kalender.
Come on.
but concentration. I must take a picture of this.
Go away, Rohan. Come, join us. Here's a book.
At this rate, I'll have to. You guys won't allow me to retain my number one position.
Very funny. Ha ha ha.
Oh, come on. But where's your mother, India? She will...
You are so right, Rohan. I'm always available when you need me.
Mother, never thought we'd see you again.
You can count on me.
She must be from Vodafone, the network that never lets you down.
What is it this time, my munchkins?
I am confused about the Aryans and the Dravidians.
That's really simple. The Aryans are believed to have come from the plains of Central Asia, whereas the Dravidians inhabited the south of India. Am I right, Mother?
Absolutely, dear. Many crossed the mountains and came into this country we now call India. A powerful king, Cyrus, from Persia, conquered the Indus Valley and made Taxila the capital of his province. Types of gold and silver coins and a new type of script were introduced.
Didn't Alexander also conquer India?
Of course he did. He wanted to conquer the whole world, so he didn't just stop at India. He advanced to Babylon, but some of the Greeks stayed back and made India their home. To know about Chandragupta Maurya.
And I want to learn about the kingdoms in the south of India. I'm told.
Guys, you can't study everything in the book. Indian history is long. To succeed in an exam, you must do selective study. See,
to succeed in an exam, you must begin early and have a thorough knowledge of the content. Chandragupta Maurya.
Mother, sorry to interrupt. We will have to take Rohan's advice as the time is short now and do selective study.
If you say so.
I was reading about the Kalinga War. Was it really so bloody?
More than you can imagine.
Why did it take place?
Greed, Sarah. Greed.
Rohan is right as always. Like any other king, Ashoka wanted to make his empire bigger and stronger. So he attacked Kalinga with a large army. The people of Kalinga fought bravely but were overpowered by Ashoka's might. Even though he won the war, he wasn't happy to see the least. He was horrified seeing the death and destruction.
That's why he took a vow never to use a sword again.
And he gave up hunting and killing and embraced Buddhism.
To spread the message of peace across his kingdom, he carved out these edicts on pillars of stone and put them up in every corner of the country.
Didn't he write these messages in Pali, the language of the common man?
You guys are really getting good at history.
All thanks to Mother, who brings everything alive before our eyes.
Mother, tell us something about the Rajput era.
The Rajputs were actually the descendants of foreign tribes, such as the Sakas and Huns.
they ruled over several small states for about 200 years.
I wonder what kinds of clothes did the Rajputs wear?
Haven't you seen the film Padmavat?
Of course not. I don't care for Bollywood movies at all.
I remember their mirrorwork outfits. What handsome guys and those stunning women.
them a big hand.
We could go back to that era. All this dancing must have been fabulous.
It looks fabulous from a distance. The Rajputs were constantly at war with themselves and others.
Why did they fight among themselves?
Let me ask you, why do you fight among yourselves? Petty jealousies, mistrust, and one-upmanship were among the many factors.
That's what must have made it easy for Mohammed of Ghazni to invade these kingdoms.
You amaze me, Paji, with your depth of knowledge.
My blood boils when I think of the loot and plunder. Mohammed of Ghazni raided India 17 times and carried away priceless gold and jewels.
Yes, it was unfortunate, but history is replete with stories of conquerors that did just that. Whether in Asia or Africa or anywhere else in the world. What is even more unfortunate? In today's India, many Indians are indulging in acts such as looting one's own country.
Didn't know you were a political commentator too, Mother.
Rohan, please talk respectfully to Mother. Don't...
No worries, Michelle. I rather like Rohan's sense of humor. Rohan, history and politics are two sides of the same coin.
Thank you for enlightening us, Mother. Without you...
I want to know more about Akbar. Mother, what a great king.
Yes, he's my favorite ruler. Kind and just and noble.
She's thinking of Hrithik Roshan, not the real Akbar.
Come on, Saira. Let's see if you remember who was Akbar's father or his son.
All these names are confusing, Mother.
Come here. Let me show you this flowchart. That's what helps me to memorize these names.
What is more important to remember is that the Muslims who came to India brought with them a new religion and a different way of life. As they settled here, a beautiful fusion took place, which led to several innovations such as Indo-Islamic architecture, the dance form Kathak, the sitar, and the tabla.
Not to forget the changes in dress and food. The pajama, kaftan, and salwar kameez came in. And the most important, my favorite biryani.
Yes, we know you're a foodie, Sid. You know, I did learn Kathak for a few years. I wish I hadn't given it up. It's such a graceful dance form.
चल मत सवारी
शाम रोक लई और चक मुख चूम लई मुख चूम लई मुख चूम लई सर से मोरी चुनरी गई 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 सर से मोरी चुनरी गई सरक 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 सरक
द मुगल्स श्योर न्यू हाउ टू हैव अ गुड टाइम
You've got it wrong, Michelle.
Yes, amend it, Michelle. Generation Y knows how to have a good time.
No, that's not what I meant. You have used the term Mughal wrongly. It was only the dynasty founded by Babur that came to be called Mughal.
Because Babur's mother's side of the family was connected with the Mongols. Mughal was the Persian word for Mongol.
Absolutely right, Sid.
Wow, Sid. Your brilliance is shining through now. Continue, Sid.
Well, I don't know much else, but Babur won the first battle of Panipat against Ibrahim Lodhi because Babur had excellent horsemen and guns. And so, he was proclaimed Emperor of Delhi.
After Babur came Humayun, and then Sara's favorite, the great Akbar.
About time too. Jokes apart, Saira. Akbar was not only a great commander, but also an able ruler. Under Akbar, the Mughals came to be accepted by people of all religions in India. Akbar believed in harmony. Even the Rajputs who were defeated were treated honorably and made viceroys of large provinces. He used to invite holy men of all faiths for religious discussions.
Didn't he start a new religion called Din-e-Ilahi?
Yes, he did. He thought the new religion would end all religious warfare. But unfortunately, it didn't.
Mother, don't you agree that most wars have been fought in the name of religion?
You are so right, Sydney. However,
I think religion should be abolished.
I second that.
Let me complete what I'm saying. Religion is a way to connect with the divine, to get a sense of fulfillment for oneself. It is one's own belief system. Religion becomes a problem only when people become intolerant, when you try to show that your religion is better than the others. That's when problems arise.
Which religion do you like, Mother?
He is asking that question to a goddess?
I respect all religions, dear boy.
That's spoken like a true politician.
I like Sufism, Mother. That's the kind of religion that fascinates me.
Mysticism, huh?
And after Akbar came Jahangir, followed by Shah Jahan.
Who does not know Shah Jahan?
Yes, Mumtaz Begum. Tell me all about him.
Oh, shut up! Don't say you dislike the Taj. It's one of the seven wonders of the world.
Every Indian worth his salt takes credit for the Taj as though he has built it himself. Don't get me wrong. I'm not complaining. I admire the Taj for its amazing architecture.
It's what brings a tourist to India. And that's good for our economy. I wish the Mughals had continued to rule over India. They would have built some more splendid monuments.
You would have also had wicked Aurangzebs to deal with.
I have read that Aurangzeb was a great ruler.
Don't be ridiculous. Rohan, she's gone completely batty.
But read this, Sid. See?
I agree with you, Sid.
No, guys, you don't.
Of course, we know.
Oh, stop it, all of you. I don't think any of you really know. When in doubt, call Mother. Mother, Mother.
Of course, our history helpline.
Here I am.
Why am I not surprised?
Hey, guys, you don't even know how to debate on an issue? First, you have to listen to the person and then respond. Getting all heated up won't get you far.
Fine, fine. And so wise, Mother. What is your take on Aurangzeb?
Aurangzeb had no vices. He walked the straight and narrow path, and he was a good administrator. However, he was intolerant of other religions. He was unjust at times. That made him unpopular and ultimately led to his downfall.
And my hero played a big role in his downfall.
Really? Who is this hero?
Don't act so dumb. He's talking about the brave Maratha leader, Shivaji.
Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj ki jai.
Oh, now I understand.
Shivaji is a greatly admired ruler for various reasons.
His strategic planning was great, Mother, wasn't it?
Yes, his guerrilla tactics helped him to fight the mighty Mughal army.
We need some guerrilla tactics to get rid of all knowing, Mother. What say?
I love the story of his escape from Aurangzeb's prison in the fruit basket.
What about his encounter with Afzal Khan? Afzal wanted to kill him using treachery, but my hero came well prepared. Shivaji had worn a suit of metal under his tunic. He hid a dagger up his sleeve, and in the palm of his left hand, he held the Baghnak. When Afzal Khan embraced him and tried to strike him with his sword, Shivaji made use of his weapons and brought an end to Afzal Khan's life.
What a gory end!
All battles are gory, Michelle, and this was no different. What distinguished Shivaji from other rulers was his true concern for the well-being of the common man.
Your hands up. Let's welcome Shivaji. We'll be right back.
रोके तो हम तूफान, तूफान रोके तो हम आग का दरिया। अब गुलामी की जंजीर नहीं सिर्फ जीत का गुलाल होगा।
Come on, parents. Let's clap for them. Come on.
बचने ते धड़क धड़क ढोलता से धड़क धड़क भंडारा जिड़क जिड़क मल्लारी धड़क धड़क भड़क सली चटक मटक फटक सली दुश्मन की देखो जो लावली।
All your hands up, parents. Come on.
Rohan, I'm truly impressed with Shivaji. If only the Maratha rule had been well established, the British could never have enslaved us.
Not every Maratha had the charisma or ability of Shivaji.
Power corrupts.
And absolute power corrupts absolutely.
You are so right, Sydney. Shivaji's son Shambhaji gave himself up to sensual pleasures and got killed in the process. Have you noticed? That seems to be the case with all dynasties. Mother, kings are supposed to be wise. Why didn't they understand that if they did not care about the people, they would lose their power? Michelle, you've made an excellent point. In fact, that's why we study history, to learn from our past mistakes.
No one seems to have learned much, I'm afraid.
I couldn't agree with you more. rulers must practice servant leadership to be able to survive.
Servant leadership?
Yes, they must engage in service of the people. The Peshwas were supposed to be good administrators. Bajirao I was a brilliant military commander, but those who followed him couldn't sustain their grip on the Maratha Empire. In the third battle of Panipat, the Maratha army was completely routed. The dispirited Maratha chieftains began to quarrel among themselves, and the Maratha kingdom broke up into five independent states: Baroda, Indore, Gwalior, Nagpur, and Pune.
Rest in peace, Marathas.
The conditions were ideal for the European traders to become rulers.
You mean the British, right?
Yes, but trading had already begun with the advent of the Portuguese in 1498. They were followed by the Dutch, the Danes, the English, and the French.
In 1600, a small group of English merchants formed a company called the East India Company. Soon, they obtained permission for trade from the Mughal Emperor Jahangir. In return, they promised to protect the merchants and the pilgrim ships of the Mughals from the Portuguese. Little did they know how costly this protection was going to be.
The English settled into their life here comfortably, bringing elements of their culture and, of course, the language that we are speaking now.
Storybook, the world is brave and good. A hero takes your hand, a sweet love will follow. Let your smile light up the sky. Keep your spirit soaring high. Trust in your
Come on, parents, let's clap for the pre-primary class. Come on. Let's encourage their parents. Come on.
Mucha mama, ani ao santa tuca. Unda mucha mama, ani ao santa tuca. Ani mazori chapila lagi selu madinaka. Ani mazori chapila lagi selu madinaka. Undir mama I love, ani pachi ponali pulo. Undir mama I love, ani pachi ponali pulo. Ani mazori chapila nataka yaka kasa hilo. Ani mazori chapila nataka yaka kasa hilo. Ya ya ma ya ya. 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 Ya ya ma ya ya.
Oh Mari
Maria Pitache.
Hey,
oh,
hey.
Maria Pitache. Oh, Maria Pitache. Hey, oh, Maria Pitache. Hey, oh, Maria Pitache. Oh, Maria Pitache. Oh, Maria Pitache. Hey, oh, Maria Pitache. Hey, oh, Maria Pitache. Barra da tama, meluzi, estreita e comprida. Barra da tama, meluzi, estreita e comprida. Alegre na entrada, meluzi, triste na saída. Alegre na entrada, meluzi, triste na saída. Hey! Por amor da faixa, meluzi, eu fico soldado. Por amor da faixa, meluzi, eu fico soldado. Fazer a sentinela, meluzi, levar chicota. Fazer a sentinela, meluzi, levar chicota. Everybody! Oh, Maria Pitache!
Let's go! Oh, Maria Pitache! Come on!
Oh, Maria Pitache! 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 Oh, Maria Pitache!
Hey, hey!
Oh, Maria Pitache! Oh, Maria Pitache! Maria Pitache!
Woohoo!
British.
To tell you the truth, Nihal, the ordinary people went on with their daily struggle to make ends meet. They didn't really know or care about which ruler came and which one went.
There wasn't any 24-hour news channel and more importantly, no internet.
The Indian freedom struggle interests me deeply, Mother.
Which aspect, Saira? It was spread over hundreds of years.
Very difficult to pinpoint. The role played by the Rani of Jhansi in 1857, the social reformers like Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar, of course Gandhiji. I can go on and on.
Hello, Saira. Your mind is all muddled up. It's jumping like a monkey from one century to another and one event to another. You aren't going to be able to answer any question.
Quite so, Saira. You've got to focus on events and people to understand things clearly.
Also places, Mother. For instance, Bengal played a huge role in our freedom struggle, didn't it?
Sure.
Chitto jita boy shunnu, uccho jita shir, gyan jita mukto, jita griher prachir. Apuna prangno tole, dibosho shorbori, বর্ষধারে রাখে নাই কণ্ড ক্ষুদ্র করি যেটা বাক্য হৃদয়ের উৎস মুখ হতে উৎস শিয়া উঠে যেটা নির্বারিত সোটে দেশে দেশে দিশে দিশে কর্মধারা ধায় অরস্রু শাস্র বীর চরিত তার্ত থায় যেটা তুচ্ছ আচারের মরুবালু রাশি বিচারের স্রোতপাত ফেলে নাই গ্রাসী পর ছেড়ে করে নি ষোটোঢা নিত জেতা তুমি সর্বকর্ব চিন্তা আনন্দের নেতা নিজ হস্তে নির্দয় আঘাত করিপিত ভারতের সে স্বর্গে কর জাগরিত
That's gone above my head. What was that? That was Rabindranath Tagore's famous Prayer for Freedom in Bengali.
She knows all the languages too. Soon I'm also going to start worshipping her.
If we are going to focus on places, then why leave out Punjab? I like the role played by Bhagat Singh and Sukhdev.
But they chose violent means to show their love for their country. What say, Mother? Are you in favor of bloodshed?
I would never favor violence over peaceful ways of achieving one's ends.
But those were desperate times, and they called for desperate measures. Do you think what General Dyer did was peaceful?
What did he do?
Oh, Michelle, don't you remember Jallianwala Bagh? On 13th April, 1919, 20,000 people had gathered to hear their leaders, General Dyer, who had earlier declared all public meetings illegal, decided to teach the Indians a lesson. He proceeded to the place with 150 fully armed soldiers. He blocked the only exit and without warning, ordered his men to fire.
Since Jallianwala Bagh was surrounded on all sides by high walls, there was no way the people could escape. More than 300 were killed and thousands injured.
How could any human order the killing of innocent men and women?
I can show you many humans who have done just that all over the world.
And they continue to do so. Right, Mother?
I'm afraid you are right, Sid. The human being is capable of as much goodness as it is of evil. Often, man chooses evil, but the human spirit is so resilient that it recovers. Punjab has seen a lot of bloodshed over the years, but it always bounces back.
That's what I call the balle balle spirit.
Your hands up.
Guys, guys, that's the sort of spirit you need to face the exams.
Please don't remind us of the exams.
Why? That's the whole reason we are discussing history, right? Otherwise, we have got lots to talk about. Football, music, and much more.
I'm feeling much more confident now about facing the exam.
There you go. Don't forget to read about Gandhi. That's a sure question.
That's the most fascinating part of modern history. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi gets my vote. Do you know what Albert Einstein said about Gandhi?
Of course I do. Generations to come will scarce believe that such a one as this walked the earth in flesh and blood.
Yes, Gandhiji was brilliant. The salt satyagraha was such a simple and yet defiant act that caught the imagination of the whole country.
Make the cloth. That makes our poverty. Bring me the cloth from Manchester and Leeds that you wear today, and we will light a fire that will be seen in Delhi and in London. And if, like me, you are left with only one piece of homespun, wear it with dignity.
पुकारे आ जा रे अब आ जा रे भूले
ऐनक पहने लाठी पकड़े चलते थे वो शान से, जालिम कांपे थर 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 सुनकर उनका नाम रे।
Let's see all your hands up, parents. Come on.
Most appeals to me about Gandhiji. He was such an inspirational figure that people all over the world have adopted his techniques and succeeded.
Of course, the most famous among them are Martin Luther King Jr. and Nelson Mandela.
If only Gandhi had lived longer, India would have been a different country.
If only won't take you far. I believe that every human being must play his or her part with conviction to bring about change.
And what about goddesses? She is absolving herself of all responsibility.
Unfortunately, independence came tinged with sadness, didn't it, Mother?
Yes, partition was a sad reality. I suppose the price of freedom had to be paid.
And India's troubles didn't end with independence, did they, Mother?
No, they did not. The question of bringing small kingdoms into the fold of the new India was the most important challenge.
The task of taking over these states and merging them with the rest of the country was accomplished by Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, the Iron Man of India.
Another famous son of Gujarat.
Oh,
tara rangila tara rang ber jue tari vaat choga tara oye chogila tara oye rangila tara rang ber jue tari vaat.
All your hands up, parents, come on.
Nervous before the results are declared.
Me too. The exams weren't so bad this time, especially history.
Come on, who would like to play Garba with me? I like the new name you've given me, Mother India. Rohan, friends?
Friends.
But why did you disguise yourself, Auntie?
To add a little mystery to history lessons. That's why.
To make sure you Dumbo study well.
Oh, Auntie, you are the best.
Yeah, 3 cheers for Auntie.
Hip hip hooray! Hip hip hooray!
That's enough. It's time to celebrate.
Not yet. Let the results be declared.
But they have been declared. The good news is that all of you have passed.
And the bad news?
How shall I say it? There is no bad news. The best news is that you have done extremely well in history.
Yay!
And Nihal is the topper.
Me?
Here are your mark sheets.
Now we can get back to normal life. Get up late, watch TV, play football.
You deserve a little recreation indeed. But may I give you one more bit of gyan? The woods are lovely, dark and deep. But I have promises to keep. And miles to go before I sleep. And miles to go before I sleep.
That's Jawaharlal Nehru's favorite poem.
So what are you trying to say?
All I'm trying to say is, don't forget the lessons of history, take inspiration from the great men and women, and do your bit for your country.
for the world too. Just thinking of the country is too narrow. We are global citizens.
Indeed, Rohan, right as always. Today, India is at the cusp of greatness. From being a country which did not possess the technique to make pins and needles, India has risen to be the seventh largest industrial nation in the world. It boasts of the largest scientific and technological manpower in the world.
I am so proud of our Chandrayaan mission and the Mars orbiter.
Yes, we've come a long way in 70 odd years, but there's lots to be done. India is progressing by leaps and bounds, but the poverty and illiteracy is keeping back many of our people. But you are the future. I look at you with hope that you will set right what's wrong in today's India and take us forward.
Yes, we will.
All right, parents, how are you doing today? What a fabulous show. You need to be louder than that. Let me see all your hands up and please stand up. Come on, come on, come on. All mummies and daddies, please stand up. Come on, come on, come on. You know when I enter means what? All right. So, today we have a fun segment. Okay? Come, come, come. Okay, first let's warm up. Let's see jazz hands. Oh, people are there in the balcony also. Hello. Hi, kids. Stand up, stand up. Okay, let's see who's louder. The people in the balcony or people here? Kids, let me hear you shout. See the kids' energy. Parents, let me hear you shout. Not bad. Very good. So today I have something fun for you. Okay? You know if I come, I'll make you dance. But today I have something fun. Okay? First, I want all the daddies. So I want at least 10 daddies to come on stage. Come on. Or, okay, if not 10, 5 daddies. Come on, 5 instructors, come on stage. Come, 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 daddies. Mummies, nudge your daddy. Nahi to hilne wale nahi hai. Chalo, chalo, daddy, jaldi karo. Auditorium is available, come on, only for 1 more hour. Hurry up, daddies. Ha, very good, clap for daddy number 1. Daddy number 2. Instructors, please come. Yeah, but that's the problem. That's why today's daddy special. Come on, daddies, come on. We don't have to dance, don't worry. It's a fun thing we are doing today. So go and stand in front of one instructor. Oi, sorry, 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 sorry. Aramthi, aramthi. Ready? So how many daddies do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many instructors? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One more daddy. So that the instructor doesn't feel alone. Come on, one more daddy. Come on. Anyone. Yes. Very good. Kids, you can sit now. Thank you. See how sweet they are. You sat before only and they're your kids and your daddies. Oh, your husbands. Come on. Thank you, sir. Come on. How? Okay, so we have. So each daddy has one instructor? Yes. So now what we are going to do is I will give you 1 minute. Okay, on the stopwatch. Whichever daddy does the maximum push-ups, pasi gaya. Okay, whichever daddy does the maximum push-ups in 1 minute, okay, gets a prize. Now, what is the prize? You get a 50% scholarship voucher from Shamak Davar International for our evening dance classes. And it's valid for 1 year, any one batch in the year. Okay, so you get a 50% scholarship. So it's not just free. Okay? Yes? Yes, are we ready? Yes. Mummies and daddies, are we ready to cheer them? Yes. Kids on top, are we ready? Yes. Chalo, stopwatch kaun karse? Ready? 1 minute. Okay, so instructors, you have to wait. Music will start. Wait. Yeah, you can start warming up. Do some wrist rolls. Yes. Puneet, warm up. Come on. Ready? Sir is ready. Are we ready? Parents, we are not judging them. We are just counting and seeing who's doing good, okay? Zareen ma'am, are we ready? Yes, come on. Hit the music. Wait. And go. Come on, audience, make some noise. Break, लेने करो. Take a break. No stress. Seconds extra. Clap for them. Very good. Chalo. Khushbu, ma'am. Daddy number one has done?
38.
Osu, clap for him. This mummy's like, oh. Very good, 38. Good job. Come on, daddy number two?
23.
Whoa. Yes, daddy number three? 28. So far, who's leading? 38. Okay. Come on. Next, daddy.
18.
Very good. 18 bhi kariya na.
75.
Huh? We have to do a recheck of this. Yeah, but very good. I saw. Very good. Next, daddy.
35.
And next, daddy?
30.
I don't believe. Daddy, show me a few push-ups. Just show us. One. Show me. Nahi, thaki gaya. Okay. No problem. So the winner is with 70? 75 push-ups. That's the highest this year. Congratulations, sir. Let's do a group picture. Group picture, instructors. Where's your wife? Ma'am, you want to come up? Come. When sir is 75, he will remember this day. Come. Group picture. Clap. Thank you so much, daddies. Thank you. Very sporting. Thank you. Clap for them. All right, now it's the time for the lights. Don't off karo, aaj chhe time. SPB is changing costume. All right, so now it's time for the mummies. Don't worry, it's not about push-ups. Okay, mummy saying thank God. It's about crunches. No, I'm joking. All right, all mummies, come on, let's go. Mummies, the floor is unlimited. So you can even have 10, 20 mummies. Come on, let's go. Come on, mummies, it's nothing to do with exercising. It's to do with dancing. So let's have first 10 mummies. Let's see 10 mummies first. Come. Yeah, pull. Only mummies, huh? All right, chalo. Done. Okay, you want to come? Come. You want to come? Chalo. Space out, instructors, all girl instructors, help them space out. Come. Space out. Please come. Mummies only? All right, space out. Okay, now mummies, what do we have to do? Okay, very simple. Okay, we'll play some music and you have to freestyle. Okay? The mummy that gets the maximum hoots and cheers wins the voucher. Yes? Mummies, are we ready? No? Are we ready? No, then go down. Come on, we have to be ready. It's sawal hai voucher ka. Come on. Yes, are we ready? Parents, are we ready? Now you have to see clearly, you have to hoot and cheer for the mummy at the end, okay? That's how I'll know who's the winner. Yes, parents? Ready? Instructors, are we ready? Come on, come in this. Let's be visible. Ready? Hit the music. Come on. Now starts the cheers and hoots. Okay, SPB is ready. All right, yes. Mummy, come on. Clap or cheer for this mummy. Good. Come on. Oh, let's do it this way. She's Masi. Okay. She's saying, I'm Masi. Okay. I'm classy. All right, ready? That is very bad. Okay. Joke. All right, so come on, shout which mummy. I know you don't know the names, but you can just say blue, green, orange, black. Who? White? Okay, white. Some say white. First one. Really? Some more, just for... Actually, I'll tell you the truth. I've decided already, but I want some noise and hooting. That's right. So tell me, which one? Which one? This mummy? Kids also, you can say, huh? Which one? Okay, so she's in the running. Next. Tie nahi, ek kach coupon che. Cover. Come on. Alright, good. Alright, so I think this mummy wins. Please come center. Ma'am, you want to give away this coupon? I'll only do it? Okay. Congratulations. All the mummies, come. We are all winners because we are on stage. Thank you so much. Thank you. All right, blackout. Yeah. And now, this year, we started a new batch, something new in Universal Tardeo. The next song is performed by the Special Potential Batch, which is known as Shamak's Potential Batch, where we select different one or two students or three students from every standard. And apart from their regular dance, which happens, we train them intensively in another batch
clubbed batch of the whole school intensively in dance, and they have a separate workout and a separate dance and separate technique training. So this is the SPB batch of Universal Tardeo. It's a mixed batch of the whole school with potential students from different classes. So let's hear it for them, parents.
Y'all haters corny with that Illuminati mess. Paparazzi catch my fly, my fly, my fly. My daddy Alabama, mama Louisiana. You mix, 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 mix that trio, make the Texas Bama. Sauce in my veins, but I see it, I want it.
Baile todo le hacen coro, te deja macao como el zorro. No pierdo mi tiempo, es oro. Todo me lo gasto, no ahorro.
Más chica, más chica, más chica. Más chica, más chica, más chica. Más chica, más chica, más chica.
Turbo
Nitro en la máquina. Siempre para adelante, nunca para atrás.
Aquí estamos duros, somos global.
Estoy muy borracho y no puedo más. Y no puedo más. Estoy muy borracho y no puedo más. Y no puedo más.
Más chica, más chica. Oye, con más chica. Más chica, patata, más chica. Machica, harata, machica, 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 machica.
5, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Level up, 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 level up.
All this on me so yummy, all this sauce so yummy. No, you want this yummy, yummy all your time.
Level up, level up, level up, level up, level up.
Give them a big hand. All right, parents, do you want some more? You need to be louder than that, parents. Come on, do you want some more? All right, now we have the curtain call, which will showcase all the classes one last time. So let's see all your hands up in the air and a lot of hooting and a lot of shouting. For the curtain call, hit the music!
Five, four, three, two, one.
All your hands up, Eric, come on!
Here's a mela, hey! Here's a kela, hey! Yeah, mela, yeah, kela, hey!
Hey.
All your hands up, parents. Come on.
What an evening we have had, ladies and gentlemen. One that we will remember for a long, long time, I'm sure. This evening reminds me of a quote I read some time ago. Alone, we can do so little, but together, we can do so much. Together is what we are, and only because of that, we could achieve what we have today. I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to all our guests for accepting our invitation and gracing the occasion with their presence. I take this opportunity to thank Mrs. Jesus Lal, Chairman of Universal Education, Mrs. Pinky Pujara, Director, Head of Schools, and all the other dignitaries for being the support that we can always fall back on. I express my gratitude to Shamak Davar and his team of instructors for designing and choreographing the dance sequences for tonight's show. A special thank you to Furtado School of Music and Rael Padamsi's Academy of Creative Expression for their creative contribution towards the program. This show wouldn't have been a success if it wasn't for the grit and determination of our teaching, non-teaching, and technical staff who have been striving for this day since weeks. How can I forget the smiling faces of parents whose eyes shine with the greatest pride having seen their children put up such a good show? Thank you, parents, for being there for us throughout the journey. And lastly, the students of the Universal School who have toiled for months to perfect themselves for today. I am proud of us, and so you should be too. Thank you everyone for coming out tonight and sharing this amazing time with us. Good night.